Hi, this is Rohini from Vatech Hi-Tech Dr. Rangarajan Dr. Shakuntala Engineering College. I belong to the Department of MCA. First, I would like to thank my department HOD, Mrs. R. Lata, my project coordinator, Mr. J. Sindhil Murugan, my project supervisor, Mr. M. Shaktivel, my project joint supervisor, Mrs. P. Rekha. Now, I'm going to explain my project, and my project title is Cantalizing for Shipping Industry. This is the abstract of my project. Container leasing management is complicated due to high volatility of container demand and supply. It is proactive rather than reactive. To satisfy the lessee to lease the container in an efficient way, this application is developed. The containers are uploaded by the lessor and he specifies the details like container history, container type, container ID and container rate per year. Containers may be open top, flat rack, refrigerated, swab bodies, generator set, dry van, roll trailers, etc. After selecting the container, the user is allowed to do the payment in this application with the approval of admin. This is the existing system of my project. In existing system, there is only one option for viewing the details of the company who leased the container. Only the container details are shown to the lessee in existing system. This is the architecture diagram for my existing system. After registration and login, lessor will be shown the lessor details, and with the approval of admin, they have to upload the container details which will be shown to the lessee. Same like lessor, the lessee after registration and login, they will be shown the web pages. They can view the container details only with the approval of the admin. All these details will be stored in the database which is accessed or maintained by the admin, who is the authorized person. This is the problem definition of my project. The authentication and approval for leasing the containers by the lessee is not available in the existing system. Only viewing the container details is available. Payment is not available in the existing system. This is the proposed system of my project. In this project, the container leasing system implementation of online leasing has been done. So the lessee can lease the container by using this application whenever user needs. Once the user, that is the lessee, log into this application, the user will be shown with all the information about the containers. The lessor can upload the information and data to this application by using the approval of the admin. All the details are given by the lessee and lessor stored in the database using the SQL. After choosing the container, user is allowed by the admin to do the payments. After doing the payments, the report will be shown. This is the architecture diagram for my proposed system. After registration and login, the lessor will be shown the lessor page, and then for uploading the container details, they have to get the admin's approval. Without getting the admin's approval, they cannot upload the container details. After uploading the container details, they can view the updates of their containers. Like the same way, after registration and login, the lessee can view the lessee page and they can view the container details. To lease the container, they have to get the admin's approval. After getting the admin's approval, they can lease the container, and then they have to once again get the approval of the admin for doing the payments. After doing the payments, they can lease the containers easily. All these data will be stored in the database, which is managed by the admin, who is the authorized person. software specifications, operating system. Here I'm using Windows 7. Integrated development environment. Here I'm using Visual Studio .NET 2015 MVC. Front end Visual Studio .NET Framework 4.5. Back end SQL Server 2014. Hardware specification. RAM 4 GB. Processor dual core 2.8 GHz. Hard disk 80 GB. Modules. These are the main modules that have been used in my application. Registration, lessor, lessee, approval, payment. Module description. Registration. The lessor and lessee have to register themselves to upload container details and to lease the container from the lessor. Login. The login module is used to login into this application by using the username and password. Here all the three, that is lessor, lessee and the admin, can login using this module. Admin. Administrator module plays a vital role in controlling the actions done by the lessee and lessor. Admin will approve the lessor for uploading the container details and lessee for leasing the containers from the lessor. Without the approval of the admin, they cannot proceed further. All the data are viewed and stored in the database by the admin. Lessor. In this module, the lessor is allowed to update their container details to the admin for getting the admin's approval. First, the lessor have to request the admin for updating the leasing details. After getting the approval only, they will be allowed to update their container details to their page. Lessee. Here the lessee needs to approve the admin to move to the leasing page. After getting the approval, they can view the leasing page where they can view container details and their lessor details. Then they can fill and book the containers for leasing and request the admin for leasing the containers. Approval. This approval module is one of the important module in this application. This is a common module which is present on both lessor and lessee side to get the approval of the admin. Payment. This module is used by the user, which means the lessee, for making the payment. For this, user needs to get the approval of the admin. Without the approval of admin, they cannot do the payments. This is the data flow diagram level 0 for this application. This is the data flow diagram of my application level 1. This is the data flow diagram level 2 of my application. This is the data flow diagram level 3 for this application. This is my entity relationship diagram for this project. This is the table design for my application. The first table design will be the registration table, where the username is used as a foreign key and the email is used as a primary key. The second table design will be the login table, where the username is used as a primary key. This is the lessor upload table design, where the container ID is used as a primary key. This is the lessee leasing table design for my project, where the container ID is used as a foreign key. This is the class diagram for my application. This is the use case diagram for my application. Owner, who is the lessor, who have to register themselves first, then they have to log in. They can view the container details. They can upload the container details with the help of admin approval. Lessee, who is the user of this application, who can lease the container, get the approval from the admin and confirm their leasing and do the payments by using the admin's approval. This is the sequence diagram for my application. This is the activity diagram for my application. After registration, they have to log in. After login, the owner will view the lessor page and upload the container details, submit new container details, getting approval from the admin, and they can view the updates. Admin can view and verify and approve the lessee and lessors. After login, the user can view the lessee page. This is the table relationship diagram for my application. This is the home page of my application. If you are already registered, then you can directly log into this application. If you are not registered, means then you have to register yourselves and you have to log in into this application. This is the registration port. When it comes to registration port, it is same for both lessee and lessors. You have to fill up all the details which have been asked. There will be a domain. There will be an option called domain where you have to choose lessee or lessor. If you want to enter into the application as lessee, you have to choose the lessee option in the domain. Or if you want to enter into this application as a lessor, then you have to click the lessor option in the domain. Then you have to submit it. After submitting, you will be entered into the login port. After giving the username and password, you have to sign in to this application. You cannot sign in to this application just like that. You have to get approval from the admin for signing into this application. This is the login port of the admin. This is the username and password which is given by the admin, and they can directly log in into this application. After signing into this application, this is a view of the admin side where we can see lessor and lessee options. In the lessor side, we can see all the details of the lessors by clicking that. This option is used to see all the details of the lessee. This is the lessor approval page from the admin side. Before approving, the status will be shown as pending. After approving, the status will be shown as approved. After getting the approval from the admin, the status will be changed to approved. After getting the approval from the admin, the lessor can easily log in into this application. Here there will be two options, add containers and view containers. By clicking the option add containers, we can add the container details that we want to put for leasing, and view container details will be used to view the details of the containers. By clicking the add container option, we will be redirected to the add containers page, where the container ID will be generated automatically. The container type, we have to specify the container type, container price, container count, which means how many containers you are having, like that. Then container image, then you have to click the add option to upload the container. Then this will be the lessee side view. After registration and login, this will be the lessee side view. This option is used to track your orders. This option is used to view the purchased list of your containers. This one is the full details of the container, which is available in a PDF format. You can download it. These are the wide ranges of containers that are available. You can choose any kind of container as per your wish. If we select open top container, means it will redirect to the next page, where all the open top containers available will be shown, where you can choose the required container from required lessor. After selecting the container, you have to enter the container type, container leasing period, container date of leasing, container count. Here the container available is only 3 containers are available. Then you have to give 3, not more than 3 or below 3. Charge for leasing per container, traveling country, you have to enter the traveling country, then you have to click the submit option. You have to get the approval of the admin for lease the container. Before getting the approval, your status will be shown as pending. This is the admin side view for lessee details. Admin have to give the approval for the lessee to lease the container. Only then they can lease the container. After admin giving the approval, the lessee can view this page. They have to click confirm leasing for the further process. After admin approval, the status will be shown as approved. After clicking the confirm leasing, the lessee have to pay their amount using the Paytm app. After paying successfully, this page will be shown. You can also track your orders. This is the purchased list of the containers, which will be very useful for both lessee and lessors. If you are choosing one container, means that containers is not available, means this page will be shown, that not available page. This is the detailed report of the containers that have been leased. Merits of the system. It provides easy leasing and less time consuming, easy to order, easy to access for both the lessee and lessor, easy to make payment. It is safe and the details will be confidentially maintained and everything will be stored in the database. Lessee can view the images of the containers and choose a lessor from whom they want to buy. Limitations of the system. User can lease the container up to the availability of the containers with the lessor. Only specific types of containers can be leased and after leasing, orders cannot be cancelled. Testing, verification testing. Verification is a process of evaluating the intermediary work products of the software development lifecycle to check if we are in the right track of creating the final product. Validation testing. Validation is a process of evaluating the final product to check whether the software meets some business needs. Integration testing. Integration testing is a systematic technique for construction the program structure while at the same time conducting tests to uncover errors associated with the interfacing. Unit testing. Unit testing is conducted to verify the functional performance of each modular component of the software. Conclusion. This project has been completed as per the client requirements. In this application, the lessee can access this process to lease the different types of containers from various lessors, in which the lessee can order the containers according to their needs and to order the container and choosing the leasing period and to submit and to pay the amount to the lessor. This application can be used everywhere and it can be accessed by various lessees and lessors. By using this application, the leasing is done very easily without a face-to-face interaction and it will save time and easy to view the containers and lease accordingly. Future enhancement. Future enhancement is to develop the system by making the various payments method. We can do the payments. More types of containers can be taken for lease in the future process. Tracking of the containers can also be done in the future. Thank you.